Hi, assalamualaikum and good evening to all our listeners who tune into IIUM.FM right now. So as usual, Shay, every Tuesday, 8 to 10 p.m. Games On with us. I'm DJ Ima.
And I'm DJ Shay. So, DJ Ima.
Yes.
What are we speaking tonight?
I don't know. I just like, maybe we need to improve our English today, right? Because our guest tonight, I think.
Yeah, because our guest tonight is a very special guest.
Yep, very special guest.
All right, you want to introduce our guest?
I think he should introduce himself, yeah.
All right, so our guest, can you introduce yourself?
Hello, assalamualaikum everyone. Thank you for having me here from the students of IIUM. I'm Jasmine Jafar. I'm 25 years old and I'm an international racing driver that's currently competing in the World Endurance Championship.
Wow, international racing driver.
Yes.
Wow. Yeah, beat.
Actually, I'm very shaking and yet I'm so nervous now. So I don't know.
I think everyone
is nervous right now.
We try to enjoy our interview tonight.
Yep. Okay. Of course.
Games On, always enjoy. What is happening?
Yeah, that's true.
Okay. So, do you want to ask first?
Okay. So, why you choose to be in this industry, and maybe there's someone who inspired you to be in that, you know, in this industry? Because there's not many people out there who love to be in this industry. So maybe can you explain why you choose to be in this industry?
Well, first of all, I started at 6 years old in a go-kart track.
Wow. Six
years old in a go-kart track in Shah Alam. Honestly, it started off as a hobby. I saw little kids racing at that time. So I used to collect small toy cars, such as Tamiyas and Hot Wheels and all that, like any other boy would do.
Yeah.
But when I saw kids at that age that could race, I was mind blown. And I wanted to try immediately, and my late dad gave me the opportunity to try the following week in Shah Alam, and it grew from there. So I started something that I was really passionate about, which is cars and racing, and it gave me something that I love very much to pursue lah. So it's been an amazing journey, and I'm sure there will be a lot more to come.
I see. Yeah. From the hobby, we become a career.
Yes. You know, since 6 years old.
Yeah.
So, how long has been?
Well, I'm 25. I'm turning 26 next month. So, it's been 20 years of racing.
Yeah.
But I would say 12 years of international racing career. So I started off as go-karting, and then I went on to Formula cars at 14, and then I moved to the UK at 15 years old. The international career won't happen obviously without Petronas, because Petronas helped my career internationally, and now we're racing in World Endurance Championship.
I see. Just now you say about you collect the Tamiya Hot Wheels.
Yeah.
Do you still collect it?
You know what? I did an event for Hot Wheels earlier this year, because the amount of kids have grown enormously, and I still do. I still some Hot Wheels cars I do. I hope to visit their office soon in early March next year.
Nice.
And yeah, I mean, you know, the livelihood of it as a kid still lives on.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
Do you know when a boy, he likes to play, like collect something.
Yeah.
He will collect until he adult.
Wow. But I think not only boys but also girls. You know.
What you collect? Barbie doll.
No, not Barbie doll. Comment answer. Maybe how the since you started to collect the model, the cars model, how already you have? You know,
how many?
How many?
Not a lot, actually, because now as I grow older, I travel a lot more and I'm quite busy with other stuff that I do. I think the collection has never been my priority, but it's been my interest, you know. So it's about finding time to actually look for what I like. So, but it's a passion lah. It's a passion. Mm-hmm.
So Jasmine started from go-karting.
Correct.
You want to try today? Maybe you can be like him. You know, we started from hobby, and then you can be like him one day. You know, it's not late. It's not too late right now.
You're also about passion.
Yeah. You need to have the interest to be in this industry.
Why you ask me? Why you not? You just offer yourself to me.
Maybe one day. Okay.
All right, gentlemen. How has car racing has affected in your life?
How does it affect in my life? Yeah. Honestly, it's not an easy sport to be at because it requires a lot of sacrifices. So I had to sacrifice my school and my family to live abroad for, you know, quite a young age at 15 years old. But what motivated me was to achieve my dream, which was at the time Formula One and of course racing internationally, which is the World Championship. So to pursue that, I was very hungry, and it affected. I wouldn't say my personal life because I'm a normal teenager at the time, but I wanted to achieve what no other Malaysian could. Mm-mm. So that's what motivated me to go further.
Mm-hmm. So you have the motivation from your life since a kid.
Yeah, correct. Correct.
So what we do since we are kids?
I did a lot of things until I couldn't remember what I have done during my childhood. Okay.
How are your family accept when you want to
be in this industry?
My parents were like any other parents that education was priority.
Yes.
But because I was supported by a very good school, which was Chempaka International School, and they were supportive with students with international co-curricular activities. So even when I was away, my tutor would always, we had to stay back after school to catch up. So there were students at my year that was, you know, gymnast or a musician or whatever. So the school was very supportive, and as long as that was balanced, my parents were happy about it. But it was moving abroad when racing started being as a professional career, and that was starting to be very difficult. But I did my diploma, which was in graphic design, and then soon after I pursued my career internationally.
We need a break a little bit. many questions you want to ask.
Just wait after this. We're gonna take a break for a while. So make sure to tune into IIM.FM, your campus radio.
Hello, we are back in Games with me, DJ Shea.
And I'm DJ Ima.
Yeah,
we have Jasmine here.
Yeah.
Okay, cool down. Just cool down first. Okay.
I'm cool.
Okay, so that's great. Okay, so we're going to ask you throughout your career, what are the best moments?
Best moments, okay.
Yeah.
One of the best races I did was winning Monaco Grand Prix. Mm-hmm. Now, why Monaco? Because it's one of the most prestigious race in the calendar and the toughest race in the calendar because it's on the streets, a street circuit in the south of France. Mm-hmm. So I was the first Asian to win. Wow. And the Jalur Gemilang plate over the weekend, and it was truly something touching and unbelievable. So it's a moment I treasure till today, and my family was there to treasure it, and the big bosses and the big teams were there, and I still feel like it was yesterday.
Yeah.
Is it in a team or
individual?
Individual. Yeah, wow. That was Renault World Series, which was F2. F2. Yeah, so 2015, 3 years ago now. Yeah, 3 years ago.
So you also have maybe a dark moment in your life.
Yeah. Oh, dark moments. Okay.
Your career.
You know, when I first moved to Europe, I didn't have much friends because, you know, you're in a new environment and all that.
Yeah.
After winning a lot of racing in Asia, when I moved to Europe, I'm completely nobody.
Mm-mm.
And that was really tough. That was like
for sure.
that was like a I wouldn't say dark, but challenging moment. Mm-hmm. So I needed to power through to make myself my name there. Mm-hmm. So, and I built up a name for my results, mm-hmm. and then I built up contacts, and I built up my you know, connections from there to have a good career. So mm-hmm. it took me a while, but you know, I was 15 years old, you know, mm-hmm. I didn't know what was best, but the support I had was really good.
15 yeah. years old, you are already about to UK.
Yes.
UK, right?
Yes, wow. Yes.
Alone.
Alone. Alone. Okay. I had my sister who was working there, who was my guardian, but she was working, mm-hmm. so I needed to find my way around, right? So yeah, it was challenging.
Yeah, of course it was challenging because you need to adapt yourself,
yes,
with a new,
correct,
environment.
And you in your younger
age. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, new culture.
Yes, well, I still am out of time.
That's right, that's
right. Correct.
How,
correct,
we need to adapt in a new environment, I don't think I can.
Yeah.
It will take a long time for me,
yeah,
if I need to adapt.
Yeah. Yeah, but I'm sure, like, you know, if anyone's given the opportunity, mm-hmm. you're only given it,
yeah,
once, so make the most out of it.
Yeah.
The opportunity.
Correct.
Course.
Correct. Yeah.
So, who is your idol in racing?
Ooh, I grew up watching Michael Schumacher quite a lot, mm-hmm. but actually my idol is Ayrton Senna, the late Ayrton Senna.
Yes. Okay.
He died in a crash in Italy, in 1994. But his talent, his passion, and mm-hmm. and his love for the sport, mm-hmm. is someone I have not seen till today. Only he had it. So I inspire to be like him, and I motivate myself from the passion he had. So that's why I like him. Yeah.
Yeah.
And we like, we know in racing car, we know Michael Schumacher.
Correct.
Yes.
And Lewis Hamilton.
Correct.
Do you follow them or not?
Well, you know, when I was with Petronas, we had the attachment program with Mercedes. So I followed Mercedes Formula One team, mm-hmm. for 5 years. Mm-hmm. I went to the Grand Prix. I trained with Lewis. I trained with Michael as well, mm-hmm. at the time, before his ski accident.
Mm-hmm.
So I spent quite a lot of time with Mercedes at that time. So I know Lewis. Mm-hmm. But obviously now that everyone is doing different schedules, so it's hard to keep track and keep in touch. But yeah, I get inspired by them, by the results and everything that they've done.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm my own driver as well, that I want to prove myself, you know. So it's two different fields.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's good to have an idol to make ourselves to become more better and to become like him, to become a great racer.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Don't be that. Second Lewis Hamilton or second Michael Schumacher, be a number one gentleman.
Yeah,
exactly.
Create your own name.
Yeah, create your own name.
Okay.
So we want to break
for a while. So after this, we're gonna ask a very important or a very touching moment, I think.
Yeah.
So if you guys, if our listeners want to know more about it, make sure to stay tuned. IIM.FM, your campus radio.
Hello, we are back.
Hashtag naga tak nak lepak dengan kami. Okay, so we are back. We're gonna talk more about, as I mentioned before we take a break, very touching moment.
Nice.
About
Jasmine Jaffa.
Of course, Jasmine Jaffa and his team.
Right.
Yeah. So we're going to talk about World Endurance Championship.
For your information.
Okay, so this is their first victory.
Yes, correct. Kemenangan.
Yeah, kemenangan. Okay, so it's okay. I really want himself to talk more about it. So maybe we let Jasmine to talk about this.
Can. So the first win came now 2 weeks ago in Japan, Fuji, where it was round 5 of the World Endurance Championship. It was a journey because, first of all, World Endurance Championship is a team effort. So there's three drivers per car. Yeah. So that means there's three Malaysians, myself, Nabil Jeffrey, and Weiron Tan. We all came from different backgrounds. Mm-mm. So Weiron was based in America. I was based in the UK, and Nabil was based in Italy at the time. So everyone was doing different things. Mm-mm. So we had this opportunity to come as one. The team is owned by Jackie Chan, okay. Together with his partner David Cheng, who owns a race team, and also from our support from Sepang International Circuit. Mm-hmm. So it was a joint effort to bring us to the World Championship and obviously fight for top three in the championship. Mm-hmm. So the first race, we came and finished fourth. Mm-hmm. The second race, we finished fourth. The third race, we finished second. Mm-hmm. And then Japan, we won the race. So it was a good continuation progress. We finally have the win on our belt. We have three World Endurance Championship races to go. Sorry, four, including China. And yeah, it's been an incredible journey. Mm-hmm. I feel so proud that finally we have won, created history, and we won more.
Of course.
So after this, we will race in China.
Correct, Shanghai.
Mm-mm. Shanghai.
Yes.
So do you ever dream to join this competition?
it's a dream come true. I mean, yeah. To you know, one thing about World Endurance is it's a pinnacle of sports car racing, but there's also top racing drivers who race there. You know, Fernando Alonso, Jenson Button. You know, these guys are people like myself get inspired from, but now we are racing against them.
Yeah.
So it's a dream come true, but we want to collect more trophies.
Yeah. Maybe some listener didn't know what is World Endurance Championship. Maybe you can explain a little bit about it.
So I think people are used to seeing Formula 1. So Formula 1 has a ladder, which has Formula 1, Formula 2, Formula 3, Formula 4, which goes by age. So Formula 4 is 15 to 17, Formula 3, 18, and so on. Mm-mm. So parallel to that, there is endurance racing. So there is LMP1, LMP2, and then there is another category called GT.
Mm-mm.
So I race in LMP2. Which is the feeder to LMP1. But to race in World Endurance, you can only be invited to race.
Oh.
Yeah, so you need to have results and an invitation. So from the three Malaysians, that's how we got into World Endurance Championship.
So not everyone is are going to be in the World Endurance Championship.
No.
Oh, so they must have their own level.
Yeah. Only selected entries can be in World Endurance Championship.
So you are in trio trio.
Yes.
Trio.
So who's the captain?
Well, I am because I'm the oldest. And then Nabil is a year younger, and Weiron is the baby in the trio. But you know, we work together as a team, and we do it for the pride of Malaysia.
So it's very good, you know, make Malaysia proud.
So I want to ask you about your opinion about Malaysian motorsport industry. Can you give me your opinion a little bit?
You know, it's a very big industry.
Yes.
You know, if you look at an automotive point of view, you look at it as a human development point of view, even marketeers and so on and so forth. So the whole industry is massive.
Mm-mm.
But it's gone a bit stagnant the last few years since we lost F1.
Yeah.
The cost has gone up enormously. Mm. So I hope that with the right governance and now with the new government, there is more implementation of a certain direction.
Yes.
I believe that now forming a council will be a good step, and that will give the correct governance and direction for the future. And I want to see more Malaysians to participate, not just drivers, not riders, but more Malaysian mechanics, engineers, marketeers, business development guys, so that the industry can go further for Malaysians. Yeah. Like yourself.
So our engineer for your team
mm-hmm.
is from Malaysia or
no, from Japan.
Oh,
yeah, from Japan. My engineer is Japanese, based in the UK.
Mm-hmm.
The whole team is international lah. So my engineer is from Japan. Mm-hmm. My sub engineer, which is a data engineer, mm-hmm. he is French. And then yeah, it's a mix lah. It's a mix. So you have to speak good English to be in the same page.
That's why he asked for us to good engineers to join the F1.
Yes.
Oh, I think so. That's why.
So we also can make a name with that.
Yeah.
Of course. Why not? We should try.
Yeah. If you don't try, you never know.
Yeah, everyone can do it. As long as we have the efforts to do it.
Yes.
That's
correct. Passion comes first.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Okay.
So we want to take a break.
Again? we're going to take a break again. So after this, there's still a lot of questions that we want to ask to Jasmine.
Hello, we are back in Games On. #NakTakNakDapatDenganKami.
Okay, so we're going to ask something that is, I don't think it's different, but maybe there is something that you can do besides car racing.
Oh, okay.
Your talent.
I don't know actually. So on the side, sometimes I play. I go to the Mines Lake and do wakeboarding because I really like wakeboarding. It's been a long time since I last gone because I've been so busy.
Mm-hmm.
That's one thing I've been doing as well. I'm also a presenter on Fox Sports for Formula One as an analyst. So I do about 6 Grand Prix presenting and analysing on Formula One. And then the last thing I'm doing at the moment is I just started a renewable energy company to, because obviously now with global warming and all that, I'm a believer of saving the planet. So supplying electricity via nature. That's what I'm doing on the side. Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
So maybe you can sing or play some music or what?
No, I would love to. I love music very much, but it's just time to actually enjoy it.
I just want to ask him, can you sing a little bit?
No, I'm terrible.
But isn't it stated that? Okay,
yeah,
it's okay.
I'm terrible.
However, it's good, you know, to have a what we call it, like nature lovers. So
yes.
You try to protect nature.
Correct.
So it's very good.
Correct.
It's rare to see it.
The
athlete to join this, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, the car racer, they have like not the hobby, right? But interest to having related to nature.
Yeah. I mean, it's something that I've always wanted to do, but it's one of my old friends that I knew for a very long time who was venturing into it. And I took an interest on the technology he had, and it's something that can help our ecosystem here. I think Malaysia is growing to be a developed country, and I think to be fully developed is also to help the environment. So this is the best. Inshallah.
Inshallah. Okay.
In your career, have you been
any injuries?
Yeah. Injuries, accidents.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes. I had a big one in Belgium in 2011. Mm-hmm. It was in the rain, and it was a high speed corner downhill, and I just lost control and went straight to the barriers. I had a massive bruise on my knees, but because the impact was so hard, I couldn't walk. So I was lifted out of the car, and I went to the medical center. I was on painkillers and I was on crutches, but I still raced. I still raced with painkillers, and I finished third, which was really cool.
Yeah.
That was painful. And after the race, I had to do a recovery sort of rehab.
How long is that?
That took me about probably 6 weeks. Yeah, 6 weeks to get fully back to shape. Yeah. Because of the bruise, was painful.
In tournament or just practice?
That was during qualifying. So I was qualifying to qualify for the race, but I was in a crash.
But despite the injuries that Desmond got, but he still had the spirit to go
Because of fashion.
That's why patience is the main thing that you need to have if you want to do something in what you love.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct.
So Okay, so I just want to ask a little bit, like, you know, you just posted a picture with Steve Steve Celine.
Steve Celine, yeah.
I'm sorry. Okay, Steve Celine. Maybe you can tell a little bit about him, because
you see, in racing, like myself in the automotive industry, it involves a lot of traveling, and you meet special people on the way. So I was in China recently for a conference, and I was sat next to Steve Celine. So Steve Celine was a famous, or is a famous, tuner from America, and he built a supercar called Celine, called the Celine S7. So when I grew up, I remember watching movies like Bruce Almighty and a few of these movies that had his car. So I saw the car once in the UK, and I was like, wow, this car is really cool. So meeting someone who built the car was even more special.
I knew that feeling, yeah.
Yeah, so, and he was telling me about how, you know, Asia is a growing market, and he likes the talents from Asia that he wants to bring to develop cars. Yeah. And yeah, sitting with someone like him is someone inspirational. Yeah.
It's a bit like, you know, a big achievement for us to meet someone that we like. Someone that we love, being like idol, you know.
It's like, he's like an icon in automotive industry. Yeah.
Just let us know.
I'm very excited. You know, I was like, I want to tell everyone. I just tell my, you know, my roommate that she asked me. I know he. She just asked me this morning. So who is going to be your guest tonight? I was like, Jasmine Jaffer, and she was screaming, you know. My roommate was sleeping, and it was like, oh, Jasmine Jaffer, I need to get tonight. But suddenly, she got something to do, so that's why she asked me to take video.
Okay, cool.
You know the excitement to meet Jasmine Jaffer here. Okay.
So you want to take a bit?
Okay.
I guess always take a bit more.
Always break. So make sure to stay tuned with us, Games On, only in IIUM.FM, your campus radio.
Hello, what's up? We are back right now with DJ Shea.
And I'm DJ Ima.
And our guest,
Jasmine Jaffa.
So, DJ Ima, any question you want to ask?
Okay.
Many, a lot.
A lot, actually. But I think I will just ask some questions, I think. Okay, so how did you manage your time in this career?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Actually, it involves a lot of planning. So, being a racing driver, you have to train, you have to do media activities, and as I told you guys, I'm also doing other ventures. So it's about splitting and managing your time. Time management is key.
Yeah.
And to be honest with you, on this journey, I do take a lot of rest as well. So if I don't rest enough, I'm not fresh for what I do. So I take my rest and my time management very seriously. So as long as I know and plan out my week properly, then I'm okay.
Yeah. You need to have good rest.
Yeah.
So in a week, what the time you will rest?
Okay, depends on the schedule lah. Depends. Weekly is not like a fixed thing. But now, because it's end of the year and we're planning for 2019, so it gets very busy. But otherwise, it's just time management.
You need to have your own time, but since his schedule is so busy. So it's not like us, you know. It's super busy. Yeah. So I can have your own time to rest.
Yeah, correct.
You just arrived from China, right?
Yeah.
Yesterday night. Yeah, 10
yeah.
o'clock. Yesterday, 10 o'clock.
Now he was here.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah. Okay.
So I want to ask you, what is your plan for your future?
Future, wow. Well, number one of my vision is to make motorsport as an established sport in Malaysia for everyone. As a career point of view, I want to race in an international level as long as I can and to be successful, not just to be Malaysia successful, but internationally.
Yeah.
That's my goal, and also and whatever knowledge or context that I learn on the way, I can bring back to the next generation.
Good future.
Still thinking about the next generation.
So do we have pelapis?
Pelapis right now. In the program?
Yeah.
Or not at the moment. I think the government and the ministry is planning it out lah. We have the facilities, but inshallah, with the right governance from the council, that will bring us more talents, inshallah.
Our talent be like, he can be his
name. His image, yeah. I mean, that's the goal. I mean, in any sport, we need a pelapis. So, you know, it's not just, as I said, not just drivers, but pelapis in all fields for motorsport.
Yeah, because maybe there's a lot of people out there have their own talent. Maybe they have their talent in this area, but by doing this, they can show their talent. Yeah, maybe they can be more talented, or they can be like Jalan Jaffa, who knows?
Correct. I mean, you know, it's about sharing, you know.
Yeah,
sometimes knowledge is something we all want to learn, and we should share. And especially like a growing country like us, that we want to be developed, we need to be doing it together. So that's how I feel it is.
Oh yeah, I want to ask. You know, the sport car is more to men.
Men
sport.
Okay.
Do we have a female?
Female.
I'm also curious about that.
not in my field, but in Malaysia, we do have talents. We have a girl drifter called Leona Chin. There is Geraldine Reed, who's doing touring cars, but not world championships yet. But I think in the future there will be more.
Are there involved any tournament?
Tournaments, yeah.
But not championship.
Not internationally yet.
Okay.
Tapi locally, yeah.
Just tournament in Malaysia.
In Malaysia, in Asia, Southeast Asia pun there is, but not world championship yet.
So as for now, there is not any woman categories in the championship.
No.
Toyota
Gazoo Racing, there is. I mean, that's more. There's some of the actors and the actresses that join.
Celebrity,
but that's just in Malaysia. So we need more women participation. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's good for the sport.
Maybe Dijima can join it.
Never too late.
Okay, I will try. I might be like, you know, driving usual.
That's the second question we want to ask him.
Okay.
How do you feel drive in circuit?
On the road.
Okay. Actually, it's two different exercises. Mm-hmm. So I don't really drive fast on the road. I don't drive fast on the road. Because I'm quite worried for others, you know. So I'm just being careful every time I drive. But on the racetrack, there's a lot of adrenaline. So you're like super focused and you know, you're always buzzing. So it's different scenarios. And I hate getting stuck in traffic, so I'm so used to driving fast that getting stuck in traffic just annoys me. But you know, it's the same, right? So yeah.
So you can see how the professional driver.
Yes, that's how a professional work.
Yeah, they think about others.
Safety is the most important.
Correct.
When in the circuit, they have just safety.
So, before we take a break.
Hello.
We're back. Okay.
Wait, so you are with me, DJ Shay.
I'm DJ Ima.
Hashtag nak ke tak nak lepak
dengan, kami. Alright.
Still with Jasmine
Jaafar.
So.
Okay. So, during your world championship, who is the toughest competitor to you?
Wow, okay. We have a few tough competitors. Mm-hmm. Number one is our teammate, which is one Chinese driver, two French drivers. Mm-hmm. So they are one competition. The other one is a French team called Alpine. Mm-hmm. They are also leading the championship now. It's also a mixed driver lineup. So two French drivers, one Brazilian. Mm-hmm. So we are battling against these two lah for the world title. Yeah.
Wow.
Because we don't know about more about.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that's why we a little bit.
What it's about?
Like yeah. Knowledge. But it's again.
This
we get
new
to
knowledge.
Know more.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So, next.
Okay, I want to ask. Starting for the scratch. How we can be a racer?
How can you be? Okay. There's many ways. There's many ways. So, number one, esports is a big, field to start. So esports is one of the avenues that there's different video games like Gran Turismo, Assetto Corsa, and so on. That's one avenue. Number two is go-kart. Go-kart in a lot of a lot of avenues in Malaysia. You can start in Shah Alam, Sepang, Elite Go-Kart Track. There's a lot of people that encourages newbies. And then the final one, if you are a lot older and you have a driving license, you can do a touring car. So championships like MSF, Malaysia Speed Festival. There is all Proton Saga cars or Hondas that you can do academies and learn there. So there's three avenues that you can start. Probably the most cost effective is esports and go-kart. That's the most affordable for everyone. Yeah.
So if you want to join the competition do we need to pay the fees or?
Oh yeah.
To start, yes, because you need to get recognized first, right?
Okay.
So you need to, you have to invest to start doing local championship, win, prove yourself, and then you start getting sponsors and get recognized to go further lah. It is tough because the competition is quite big. There's a lot of drivers. So like myself, I started in Malaysia for a few years, and then I went Asian, and then I went European, until the World Championship lah. So it takes a few years, yeah.
So basically, how much is someone need to pay?
Oh, okay. It depends on which sport because different cars, different fields cost differently. So, it's up to what. Your career path is, if you want to pursue in touring cars, you pursue in touring cars. You want to pursue in Formula One, you pursue in Formula One. Endurance. So, so you can, it's like studying lah, you want to do, you have a choice of doing GCSE or SPM. So you have the choice of doing, and then after that you pursue. So it's the same after that, you do A levels or foundation. So it's the same thing. It's what you want to pursue. So if this is the path you want to go, then you choose it lah. Yeah. Personal goals. Yeah.
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 So I want to ask, what is your opinion about car racer illegally.
Illegally?
Oh.
I'm not fond of it at all. Illegal street racing. Actually, I'm also the vice chairman of Road Safety Council. So, Majlis Keselamatan Jalan Raya Negeri Johor. So it's a initiative that was started by Tengku Temenggung Johor, who wanted to address this issue, which is street racing, illegal racing, also golongan mat rempit that was racing illegally, which is not good. And now Malaysians punya accident rates is very very high. There's about 7,000 accidents. So it's very high, and a percentage of it is because street racing. So I'm against it. If you want to go race, you race at the track. Yeah.
Because it's very dangerous for ourselves.
Yeah.
And also for
other people.
Yeah, other people too.
Correct.
Pay some money and you save.
Correct. Okay. Correct.
So do you think I don't know is this proper question or not? Do you think about the media affected the people who are race illegally?
The media?
Media affect people who race illegally.
Influence. The media influence. Yeah, definitely. Because, you know, this thing, it has to be, education and it has to be communication.
Yeah.
So if I tell you today don't race, that doesn't go straight to your head, right? Tomorrow you'll still do it. So why you shouldn't do it? So it's a constant education to the people, to the rakyat that it's a wrong habit to do and there's other alternatives to do it, and dari segi, motorsport, there is a lot of avenues. It's not just racing in Sepang, there is drag racing, there is drift, there is, macam-macam lah. But it's getting to educate them. And it's also the media's responsibility to keep doing it. And you know what? One of the biggest influencers is Datuk Michelle Yeoh, who is sitting on FIA, which is the automotive governing body internationally on road safety. So she is leading it, and she has done a tremendously good job for bringing the accident rates down. But this one needs time. It needs time.
Of course. And that's why, as you said before, instead of they doing it illegally, better they try to race it on track.
Yes,
better. Maybe they can be like a true car racer.
A manager can find the talent that they have. Right?
They have the talent, but they just don't know how to show it illegally.
Correct.
So you want to take a break?
Okay.
but after this, we want to play some game.
Yes.
Sure.
Alright.
So make sure to tune into.
Hello, you are back.
Again.
With me, DJ Shay.
And I'm Jema.
Hashtag nak kata nak.
Depart dengan kami.
Alright.
Okay. So
right now, we want to play
the game.
The game name is Choose Only One.
But just only one. So this game will be conducted in Malay. So it will be fun sikit lah. Oh, finally.
Finally, pada tan dah keluar.
Okay.
Alright. So, Jasmine boleh pilih lah.
Boleh.
Mana-mana. Alright, first question. Nasi lemak atau roti canai?
Roti canai.
Why?
I just love roti canai.
That's right.
Yeah.
Malaysia.
Nasi lemak pun Malaysia juga. Tapi I think roti canai lagi best.
Yeah. I tak tahan pedas actually. That's why.
Sama.
Gastri.
Gastri. So next. PUBG or Mobile Legend? Ketap.
Wow. Mobile Legend, I guess. Yeah. I don't.
You don't play the game.
It's been a long time since I've played, but my memory is Mobile Legend.
Okay.
Yeah.
Alright. Tea or coffee?
tea. I don't drink coffee.
Yeah.
I don't drink
coffee.
I don't drink tea. I love tea.
Yelah, atas orang kan. Ada yang minat ni, ada yang minat tu. Yes. Okay. Okay. So that's durian or cempedak?
Durian anytime.
Malaysia.
Durian anytime.
Durian tu adalah barat jiwa. Ah, kalau ada tu.
Agree, oh, agree.
Yeah. Okay.
Apa yang tanya?
Banyak okay. Tu.
Memasak atau mengemas?
Uish. Oh, mengemas for me. Mas. Actually, yeah, mengemas. Yeah. I'm quite OCD actually. So yeah, everything has to be teratur and color coordinated. Yeah, I'm quite.
Oh, bagus,
I'm quite, yeah, proper.
Oh, that's good.
Husband material.
Okay, next.
So you can cook?
Okay.
I can cook, but simple stuff lah. Not really, not really anything special.
You can survive lah.
Yeah,
of course lah. Kalau ada seseorang survive masa, je. Yeah. Boleh cook, boleh mengemas.
Yeah.
Hashtag husband material lagi. Okay, so next. Suka dengan lagu jiwang or rock?
Or S. Okay, maybe more jiwang kot. I don't know.
Maybe boleh bagi satu lagu yang jiwang.
Tak tahulah.
Banyak sangat ke?
Yeah, depending on mood jugalah. Yeah, depending on mood juga. But I think jiwang is quite chill kot. Yeah, mm-mm, lagi betul. More relax. So,
yeah, kalau dengan tuman-tuman dia buah-buah-buah semua tu.
Yeah. Susah sikit, right?
Like rock.
Yeah, intense sangat lah. Yeah, intense sangat.
Mm-mm, betul.
Yeah.
Kalau jiwang ni, kalau kita dengar sedih, kita dengar lagu dia. Dia boleh, apa?
Tekat lili lah.
Dia boleh fit semua mood kita sebenarnya lagu jiwang ni.
Correct.
Kalau rock ni, takkanlah tengah sedih pasang lagu rock
betul,
pula.
Betul.
Aduh. Okay, so next.
Alright, last question. Mm-mm. IG or Twitter?
Tough. I need both lah. Tapi IG is more, there's more story to tell from daripada gambar, daripada video, daripada live feed. So it's more interactive. Mm-mm. Twitter is more short stories kan, short interaction. So yeah, more IG, Instagram.
Lagipun, I think more people used to use Instagram rather than Twitter.
Yeah.
Since when you create your IG?
IG, 3 years ago, 3-4 years ago, recently juga actually. Yeah.
Twitter
lama sikit. Because I think Twitter came first kan. So Twitter 2011. Yeah, itu pun nak update. Recent updates lah. Yeah.
Okay. So
any question you want to ask?
I don't think so.
Second game. Oh, we have second game.
Nak ni. Producer kita nak main lagi, nak tengok lagi. Ni sebenarnya nak tengok ni. Okay.
Our producer just tell us we have second game. I thought we have only one game.
Okay.
So, next game is you need to answer
in 5 seconds.
Wow, okay. Right. Can.
Okay. You want to start?
Can. I'm ready whenever.
Alright. So, eat fast, right? Just let you drive. Okay. Tiga favourite food.
Tiga favourite food. Wow. Okay.
Banyak tanya.
Yeah. 5 seconds. Okay. Nasi padang, pasta, and I don't know.
Roti canai.
Thanks for Hashir, tolong.
Yeah, exactly.
5 seconds. Okay, so next question. Berikan 3 ciri-ciri perempuan idaman anda.
Wow.
Di sini je aku yang tanya.
Okay. Well, I have to cook well lah.
Of course.
I have to cook well. Career woman, and also. Smart, I guess. And pretty. Okay. All in one. All-rounder. Yes, all-rounder.
Okay, I just want to ask. Personality or attitude you choose first?
Personality. Anytime. That's my type.
Personality atas daripada?
Pandangan pertama tu.
Wah,
dia punya
tu pandangan pertama.
I say
yeah. Okay.
Alright. 3 favourite place yang nak sangat pergi.
Okay.
Dah pergi dah sampai
ke? Actually banyak places. Okay, so at the moment I want to check out more. Oh yeah, it's 5 seconds. Right? Sorry, I want to go to Turkey. South America, and maybe Oman. Muscat. Mm. Muscat looks
so,
nice.
So sebab apa macam nak pergi sangat tempat tu?
I think banyak culture, banyak history. I love old stories, infrastructure and buildings and all that.
Do you have any tournament at there?
Tak ada. Tak ada. There's no track. There's no track there. Oh, yeah, there's no track there. So Turkey ada but there's no racing there. Lah. Yeah.
Okay. So next, three things that people don't know about you.
Three things people don't know about me.
Yeah.
sometimes sorry. Yeah, sometimes I like to be alone. Alone time is me. I love to eat a lot. And I like to travel.
Wow, travel is the best thing ever.
Apa ni sambil
minum
air.
Yeah.
Alright. Okay, tiga perkara Jasmine paling tak suka.
Paling tak suka. Someone is late, I really don't like.
Terfikir juga benda tu sebenarnya.
Yeah, someone is late, I really don't like. If there's no disciplinary, also I really don't like. And also laziness. So macam, you know, procrastinate and all that. So that annoys me quite a bit. Yeah. Slow process lah. Yeah.
Betul, sebabnya macam itulah.
Betul. Disiplin,
yes. Disiplin kena ada lah.
Yeah, correct.
It's very important. Sebenarnya dalam semua benda, disiplin ni penting.
Yes.
Tapi tambah-tambah lagi dalam sport ni, kalau lambat tu tak ada disiplin, macam manalah kita nak berjaya.
Correct,
kan?
Correct. So, time management lah macam kita
Betul, time management. Alright.
Cakap tadi.
Okay, last. Tiga perkara yang Jasmine buat sebelum tidur.
Sebelum tidur, baca doa. Baca doa, obviously. I always think of what I have achieved today.
Okay.
And also what I want to achieve tomorrow.
Yeah.
So that's my three things.
Thinking about those things will motivate you more to do better.
More to do better, yeah.
Do you have to start any IG before sleep?
Start any IG?
Yeah.
On Instagram?
Yeah.
Not really. Depends lah. Depends, yeah.
Depends on mood.
Depends on mood.
Depends on, yeah, depends what I story or share lah. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so next, kita ada last question ni.
Okay.
What three things, what is really motivates you?
Three things that motivates me.
Yeah.
Maybe it's a bit cliche, but agama bangsa negara.
Yeah.
That's why I do it. Yeah. It's simple. Yeah, it's simple, but it's true.
Mm-mm.
That's why I do it, because there's not a lot of Malaysians. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So you think them first, so you can trace.
Implement, yeah, implement. Because there's a reason why I'm there.
Yeah, that's
why I do it.
Wow, so impressive.
Agama bangsa negara.
I'm so impressed. I never heard that answer before.
Yeah.
Agama bangsa negara. I bet once he said it just now, I was like, wow, masuk terus.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright.
So
we want to take a break, and after this is our last
segment for tonight.
Awesome.
So stay tuned to IIUM.FM, your campus radio.
Hello, assalamualaikum.
Alhamdulillah, ya Allah. Waalaikumsalam.
In games on IIUM.FM. With me, DJ Shay.
And I'm DJ Ima.
Hashtag nak ke tak nak.
Lepak dengan kami. So we are
sambung.
Of course. So kita dah sampai ke
Last segment.
Yeah. So this set actually.
Set.
Of course. Every slot. The last segment will be said.
Before we ask the last word from Jasmine.
So I have a question.
Okay.
What is your main objective or aim in this industry?
I think I mentioned this earlier where I want the motorsport industry to grow. I want more Malaysians to get involved because the value of the automotive industry is very, very big, as I said. But my objective personally at the moment is I want to do well in the World Championship.
Mm-hmm.
So concurrent to that is to have more Malaysians in the World Championship. That's my goal currently.
So maybe you can give any tips from the listener who want to join.
I think there's a lot of avenues. It requires a bit of research. In Malaysia, It's a growing sport, growing economy. But to all of you who wants to do it, it's accessible to everyone. You know, as I said earlier, there is esports, go kart, there is MSF, and all these avenues that you can start from. But to pursue a career, obviously you need good education and never stop pushing hard to get there.
Yeah, that's a really good tip. You know, maybe there's any last word or hope that you hope from in the industry in Malaysia, this industry in Malaysia?
It's a never-ending fight. To educate more people for the right discipline and the right direction, to give the right governance. I feel it's up to the youth to decide the future.
Yes,
you know, now that we are living in the 21st century with social media and, you know, education can be shared in many, many ways. And from that we can grow it together as a community and inshallah we will see more Malaysians up there.
Okay, so last thing is that last word for the students, IIUM students themselves,
well,
for examination and so on.
To all of you, best of luck and study hard and never stop chasing the dream.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes, thank you, gentlemen.
thank you.
So, yeah, and...
Okay, but before that, maybe there is some words from Hashi yourself.
Oh, yeah.
Since we're starting our mid-semester break next week.
So, happy holiday, guys. Enjoy your holiday and don't forget to finish your assignment.
That's the
important thing.
Important thing, yeah.
Have a safe journey. So that's all.
So as for me, I wish happy holiday to you guys. So I hope that you will spend your holiday, your mid-semester break with something that is beneficial, not to waste your time. Just as Jasmine Jaffa said, time management is very important. You can enjoy your holiday, but at the same time, think about your assignment that you need to submit. And
responsibility.
Yeah, that's why. Time management is the first thing that you need to think of.
And we want to say good luck for gentlemen for
thank
next
you.
Tournament.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, good luck for you.
Malaysian proud again.
Thank you.
Inshallah. So, that's all for tonight.
Yeah. We end off our show with... Bye-bye.
Assalamualaikum. Thank you.